If your hands-on exercise requires you to print a document and turn it in, because I don't want you giving me any hard copies of paper, a good thing to learn how to do is to use a virtual printer. Now, you could have a couple of options. I'm going to show some examples of printing to virtual printers using Excel, PowerPoint, and Microsoft Word. First, with Microsoft Excel, we're simply going to print, and you could do print preview if you want. I'm just going to go to print, and depending on whether or not your computer has virtual printers installed, you might look for something like Adobe PDF. I have installed Cute PDF Writer. I'll introduce that to the class in a separate video. This is a free virtual printer that I like to use quite frequently. But there's a good chance that you already have the Microsoft XPS Document Writer. We're going to start with that one. So select that as your printer. And notice the print dialog box. You can print specific pages if you want. I'm simply going to select that printer, click OK. And instead of actually printing to a real printer, it prompts you with a Save As dialog box. You're going to save your file, you're creating a file, to your storage location. Click Save. That document has been saved now. Let me go to Documents, see if I can find my document now. I called it Excel. Here it is right here. The Excel Virtual Printout Options. Get up on the screen where you can see it. And if I open that file by double-clicking it, you'll see that it actually opens up in a XPS viewer, or it'll open up in Internet Explorer browser. Okay? But it's a what you see is what you get type file, a WYSIWYG file. That's the Microsoft XPS Document Writer. Let's go to PowerPoint. Okay. If I wanted to print out a PowerPoint, and I'm going to print out a PowerPoint handout, choose handout, 4 slides per page. Again, I'm going to change my default printer, and this time I'm going to change to that Cute PDF Writer. Now this is something that you would have to download and install. It's going to work the same way. This saves it as a portable document format, or Adobe PDF. And we simply wait for the Save As dialog box to appear. And again, we would save this file as with a name and to a location. Again, I'll save it to my Documents folder. And notice this one shows up with the PDF file extension and icon. If I double click it, it opens up in the Adobe Reader. A virtual printout rather than a hard copy printout. And again, there's the Microsoft Word. Now this one is going to be a true experiment because I have never used the Adobe printout. I'm going to send it to the print. I'm going to choose my printer as Adobe PDF. I've never actually done this before. Print. Let's do this. Let's do. Once again, we'll go to the Documents folder. And there it is as a PDF file. And it shows up just as a PDF file. Okay. So that's how you can use virtual printers. Now, if you don't have virtual printers installed on your computer, then you can search for that Cute PDF online, get the free version, and install it.